Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to tell you of the legend of a woman for whom her beauty was the biggest curse. Let me tell you of the story of Deirdre of the Sorrows. This story happened in a time when Ulster was at peace, and the people indulged in sports and feasts. King Concobar Mac Nessa reigned during this time, and his warrior chiefs, the Red Branch, were respected all over the land. Since everything was peaceful, it became a tradition that each chief, one after the other, would organize the big feasts for the other chiefs, and the king of course, and every chief would try to make the feast the best feast they ever had. One day it came to pass that Phelim's turn to organize the feasts came. Phelim was eager to prepare the best feast ever, and even though he wasn't a warrior chief, but one of the greatest bards and storytellers, he was widely respected under the other chiefs, and so it was no wonder that every chief and the king himself were eager to attend the feasts and hopefully hear some kind of poetry or song from Phelim. As the king and the chiefs arrived, a storm began to rage, and the king, being very superstitious, started to get worried. That wasn't exactly the start Phelim has hoped for his feast. But after a while, the king started to relax, and so did the chiefs, and started to have the best of times at Phelim's feast. The festive mood was abruptly ended when a harrowing scream imbued the whole castle. It turned out that the scream came from the chambers of Phelim's pregnant wife. But it wasn't the wife who had screamed. Instead, the scream came from her unborn child still in her womb. Phelim was worried for her and his child, and so he called for the great druid, Cawod, to look after them both. Cawod examined the mother and went pale. He refused to say anything, and he only started to speak up when the king himself ordered him to. Cawod announced that the child would be a girl of great beauty. She would grow into the most beautiful woman in all of Ireland, and into a woman of great virtue and love. But her beauty would be her doom, and bloody battles would be waged for her affections. She would bring great suffering and death over the man of the king. As soon as the druid spoke those words, the men started to argue, and whilst they still argued, the baby girl came into the world. As soon as the child was born, the men demanded her death, and even though Phelim begged and pleaded for the life of his own daughter, the king let the child be brought before him. But as soon as the king and the men saw the beautiful little baby, well, they weren't really able to kill her, because it would be a sin to kill something so pure. So King Concobar spoke up and declared that no one would touch this child. He himself would protect her from the prophecy. She would grow up where no one could find her, and when she was of age, the king himself would marry her. And so, the baby was brought to a secret place and raised by a maid named Leocrum, who was a woman of great wisdom and with a lot of skills. She was even said to be a sorceress. The girl, which they called Deirdre, grew into a beautiful woman, and she was a woman of wisdom and knowledge way beyond her years, thanks to the education given from Leocrum. One snowy day, though, it happened that Leocrum slaughtered a cow for herself and for Deirdre. Deirdre, who was horrified by the sight, declared she would only love a man who had the three colors she saw there before her. A skin as white as the snow on the ground. Cheeks as red as the blood dripping from the calf's body. And hair as black as the raven which fed from the cadaver. Leocrum, before even realizing it, told her that this man exists. Nisha, the son of Uisnech, was exactly who she was talking of. Deirdre begged her to introduce her to him, but Leocrum declined and told her that she was promised to the king. But fate hid when Deirdre was in the forest for a walk and she met no one else but Nisha, who was out hunting. She instantly fell in love with him, and knowing that her wedding day with the king was about to come, she begged Nisha to elope with her. But Nisha also knew about the orders of the king and refused at first. But, well, He knew, as well as Deirdre did, that they were in love and that they wouldn't be able to part, really. And so, after a while, he summoned his two brothers, Arden and Anil, and they left Ulster, taking Deirdre with them. Deirdre and Naois married and loved each other dearly. But as soon as King Concobar found out about this, he sent his men to retrieve Deirdre. The newlyweds had no moment of peace and fled the rage of the king. There was nowhere in Ireland they could rest and be safe, since everyone feared the wrath of the king. And so they fled Ireland to Scotland. The sons of Uisnech entered the service of the king of Caledonia and became part of his army. But they never stayed within the castle walls, and always ended every day walking into the wilderness, telling no one where they were heading. Well, needless to say that this behavior didn't go unnoticed, and the king became suspicious and had them followed. It was reported back to him that the three men had a camp in the wilderness, where they were greeted by the most beautiful woman. And of course, this woman was no other than Deirdre, who cared for the brothers in the wilderness. As soon as the king heard the report, he began to want the woman for himself. But, well, he knew he couldn't kill the brothers, for they had sworn to serve him. So he simply tried to let them be killed. He put them into the front lines of every battle, one more dangerous than the other, hoping that they would be killed there. But, well, he underestimated the sons of Uisnech, for they were so great warriors that they always returned victorious. It didn't take smart Deirdre long to realize what was happening, and so she warned Naois of the danger they were in. So, well, the brothers left the King of Scotland's service and fled over the sea to a remote island, where they lived peacefully for a few years. The brothers hunted, and Deirdre cared for him, so that they wanted for nothing. But King Concobar still wasn't done with them. Knowing that he couldn't reach them, he sent his advisor, Fergus MacReith, which he knew that he was fond of the brothers. So Fergus was sent with a peace offer promising them safe return to Ulster. And Fergus was very happy about that and, well, followed the order and searched for the brothers. Even though Deirdre felt that this could be a trap when Fergus first arrived, well, she couldn't make the brothers refuse the offer to finally come home, seeing all of their friends and family again. And so they followed Fergus back to the shores of Ireland. But when they arrived on the shores of Ireland, Fergus was approached by a local man, inviting him to a feast in his honor. And Fergus, as all of the Red Branch warriors, wasn't allowed to refuse an invitation to a feast in his own honors, even though even he suspected something weird going on. Deirdre also was aware that this might be a trap, and she begged Fergus to refuse. But Fergus' honor was too precious to him, and so he went to the feast while telling his son to guard the brothers and Deirdre on their way to the capital. And at the capital, well, they were greeted by old Leocram, who brought them to a house in the wilderness, where the Red Branch normally brought trophies of the battles. Concobar, who still wanted to forgive Naois and his brothers, but also was still very jealous, asked Leocram if Deirdre was still looking as beautiful as she was before. But Leocram lied to him, telling him that Deirdre now looked like an old hag, with yellow teeth, broken fingernails, and all in all, not beautiful anymore. But the king sadly wasn't tricked as easy as that. He sent a spy, and even though the spy lost an eye thanks to Naois, word got back to Concobar that Deirdre was as beautiful as always, if not more. And so the king sent the Red Branch to kill the sons of Uisnech. They fought bravely for a while, but in the end they were so vastly outnumbered that they had no chance. First Naois and then his brothers were killed. After the death of the brothers, Concobar took Deirdre as his own wife. But no matter how much he courted her, how many gifts he gave her, she would not speak to him, or even acknowledge his existence at all. Well, she came to hate him from the bottom of her heart. In the end, it was his fault that her great love was killed. After a year of refusal, Concobar grew tired of the behavior of Deirdre and punished her in sending her to marry the man who killed her love, Nisha. Deeply despaired, she got into the chariot that was about to bring her to the man she hated the most in the world, the very man who took her true love from her. And so, when the chariot passed by a place where the cliffs hung over the road, she leaned out her head and dashed her brains out against the rock, dying there and then. In the end, she was buried next to the place where Nisha lied. But Kankuba was still so jealous that he couldn't even bear the thought of them being united in death. Well, and so he placed them apart from one another. But it happened that out of each of the graves grew a tree, and they grew and grew closer and closer together, until their branches twined together, letting the lovers embrace each other forever. This was the legend of Deirdre of the Sorrows, or at least one version of it. If you enjoyed it, please leave a like and take a look at my other videos. And if you happen to speak Irish and feel that I mispronounced one or the other name, please let me know in the comments down below how to pronounce it right. Thank you very much. See you next time. Bye!